Fast app. Because PointsBet knows every second matters. Time is money, and it pays to be fast. PointsBet has the best odds on all pro sports. So download the app now. Use code TIGERS to get super risk-free bets up to $2,000. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117.
I'm Lizzie Goodman, and welcome to Difficult Artist, a podcast about the creative process. The concept is simple. We're talking to amazing artists.
Continue this and continue to call the scum media what they are. They are hiding.
Hey, but it's, David, it doesn't. Look, in the end, we operate a business. Let me just explain how this is going to work, because I know what will happen. We're just going to stop talking about it, because we have a business to do. Meaning, we gave you our opinion, and you can do what you want with it. But until or unless more people decide to cover it, I'm not going to cover it and cost ourselves. We have check marks we need to hit. David, the bottom line is the fact that this story is seemingly, be very careful, seemingly being embargoed is stunning to me. How is it that you can't find it on ESPN College Football? What's going on in today's college football news that's bigger than Bo Schembechler being implicated in a sexual abuser cover-up? I'm sorry. You know, how do I not find it at the Free Press? How? How? It's just, and listen, I don't want anyone treated the way Michigan State got treated during their trial by fire. And they deserved most of what they got. Mark and Tom didn't. No. And ESPN reporting things that were already legally adjudicated as new news when it wasn't new news, but packaging a new news, that's intellectual dishonesty. That's a hit piece and a hit parade. I don't want that. All I want is, how can you tell me this isn't the biggest thing going on locally, and yet it's nowhere to be found? And the newspapers are up here, doing this. Today is National Cookie Day. I can go to the Free Press and hear what cookies are popular in the Lions locker room. I can't hear an opinion piece about what's going on in Ann Arbor. How? I don't care. I go to Michigan, whether I went to Michigan State or Southern New Hampshire or Grand Canyon University. I'm a human being. And it's just not covered. It's just, no one wants to get involved. I don't get it. That's all. Sorry. David, go ahead. Rico, anybody.
He's dead, and I have breaking news for you. He ain't coming back.
He's
Jason, chef's kiss to you, my brother.
You know what I'm talking about. You know it. You know all these eager beavers will be out there if this was Michigan State. Oh, please. You know what? They'd already have Biggie Munn's bones dug up, and they would have the skeleton assembled in front of Spartan Stadium. They'd have Duffy Doherty's bones right by that piece of art in front of Spartan Stadium. They'd be waving at you like this with strings. You know, it's true. It's, you know, yeah.
I'm just thinking of those little air things.
Than you would have back in the 80s or the 90s.
There's no argument. There is no argument there.
So what Wojo was trying to say is, you know, you're going to tear down his legacy. And a lot of people, a lot of people love both.
Scale argument and go, well, what was he supposed to do? We're talking about a statue, right? I'm not trying to throw the guy in prison.
I am hoping that, you know, with the quiet, you know, the silence that's coming from Michigan right now in these hours since it's become public, that they're using this time to come out with something that's going to be the most complete and appropriate response to what's happened. Because if they don't, knowing what happened with the Masterson, what happened with the
right
state, what happened with the church and the Boy Scouts, Michigan has to prove that they are Michigan and they can address something like this in an appropriate way that could be an example for any other institution that faces.
No, Jim, I think you've said it.
Taking down the statue,
right.
They'll take down the statue.
And I think that's the least they can do.
Stand back or off the hall, they'll do it. But right. If they don't,
well,
they will lose a lot of their supporters.
Jim, I think you said it right. And guess what? Penn State got the report. 10 days later, they acted. They're on the clock. Kenny, pick of the day, and we'll have some fun because this has been way too heavy for 68 and sunny today. What do you got?
It's the pick of the day. Brought to you by the BetMGM Sports Lounge inside MGM Grand Detroit.
Atlanta under vacations with family. Nights out on the town with friends. Game days with your favorite sports teams. And the thrill of live concerts. But until we can all get the COVID-19 vaccine and build community immunity, which will take time, we all need to continue to stay careful, because Michigan's recovery is depending on you, and so are your family, friends, and neighbors. So even if you're vaccinated, wear a mask, avoid large gatherings, and social distance. One day in the near future, we will all be able to put this pandemic behind us. But until then, spread hope, not COVID. Learn more at michigan.gov/coronavirus. A message from the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services.
Bring you back to going to live. recapping.
Mike, I like the club idea. You know what you got to do? You got to do a couple of things. You got to embrace the fact that people's attention span has changed. It's shorter. Mm-hmm. They're going to be on their phones. Don't try to say, get off your phones. Steer into it. Get some great free Wi-Fi service so people can get on their phone. They can do things. You know what? You could do the whole little curly shuffle and have people text in which one helmet has the, you know, the football underneath it.
Or we could can that because it's old and played out.
Well, you know. Or here's the other thing.
What was more entertaining the last 3 years of D'Antonio? The curly shuffle or our offense?
Every now and then the curly shuffle was entertaining.
Fly Lansing scoreboard, MSU offense. It's the scores of games that were over 4 hours ago.
But you never know that. But that's what I'm saying. Do things that you can do interactively with the people in their phones.
Touchdowns?
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Here's the other thing. I like the fact of having that type of club. If you have some type of an area in there, but in that area, you have to do something that nobody's ever done before. Because this is unprecedented times.
I offered it.
In that club area, and I don't even know if it has to be a club, but maybe just in kind of an open air, standing room, only type of thing.
Yes, a party deck.
With a bunch of monitors.
Yes.
Of other games.
That's right.
That you can watch the other game. You're not held hostage, especially if it's a bad game.
You need to be able to be mobile, walk around, enjoy life.
Yeah, here's a dirty little secret. Up in the press area, when it's a bag, if there's a close game that's really happening, if you go outside the stairs, there's like 5 monitors back there. You know, like the Coke machine and stuff with different games. And media members are standing there watching the ending of a particular game. It's like, oh my God, this is interesting. Same thing. Have some type of an open air beer. And yes, guys, listen, people drink at games. Okay, let's stop acting like we can't have alcohol. What about the children?
No, it's not the pro games. I mean, you could take the same thing as like you need to take the at home experience and bring it to the live experience because you're losing people.
Same thing with the pro game because if I got the ticket and I can watch every game, I can watch the Red Zone channel. You know what? How about, say, you got 10 or 20 TVs up with the Red Zone channel or some big game that's going on in the division. So if you got Packers, Bears, that means something.
Right.
Instead of checking your phone, hey, Mike, let's go get something to drink and go watch it over there where we can sit and watch that game and we can have one eye on this game.
Well, can I expand on that? Because that was going to be my idea, but I don't want it in a area where I have to walk to. I want a touchscreen television right there that's Red Zone on it, but I can see, oh, you know what? This game is close. Let me actually pull up my screen, touch that game, and I can watch the Colts Titans now.
Like an airplane.
Correct. That's what I want at my seat. I don't want to get up and have to go do it. And bring the food to me, too.
Anything else you want, David?
Anything else?
The royal penis is clean.
Right. Damn. Actually, his idea regarding the TVs embedded in the back of the seats.
Yeah, that may... Wow.
He's onto something.
You know what? You win right now.
The ability to have another game on or have, like, whether it's NHL Network, NBA TV,
correct.
MLB Network, you can just lock it in and know you're getting some programming. I don't mind that. I don't. Now, I know the Raiders nightclub thing is not for everybody. I know the amount of people that will actually sit there. It's probably not a high amount. But I'm just saying it's the thought process of it. Look, when you go back to Comerica on that day, or when you want to go to LCA or Ford Field, what are the changes they got to make that get you to go back? Yes, the team has to be good. I know that. But if the pandemic taught us anything, A, staying home ain't so bad. And B, a lot of people have said, hey, I still like sports, but I don't know how much money we're spending. So to get you back, what they need to do. Now, Rico, what he brought up, if you want to see an example of what Rico's talking about, Google Colorado State.
help you?
Can I get a double quarter pounder with cheese with just ketchup and onion? And a Big Mac, a cheeseburger, and a one large Coke.
All right, I have a Big Mac, double quarter cheese, only ketchup, only onions, a cheeseburger, and a large Coke.
Yep.
All right, your total comes out to be $14.70.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thanks.
Scary Spartans that people can do photo ops with. Then all local food vendors. It's the ring of grub.
I'm there. I'm down. I like it.
Why not, David? Why not?
Okay, fine. Let's go with
it. How about actual bathrooms? Not things that animals don't want to pee in.
That would be great. I will make a joke, but we had a serious topic problem today, so I'm gonna make it.
Wanna go to Mitch? 97.1. Mitch, what's going on, dude?
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Well, I'm good, man. Awesome. Well, I'm a Spartan fan. I've got a little something to say.
Let's do it.
All right, so I was a student back in 2010, 2011, and I don't know what happened to it, but we used to have Meet the Spartans. Like the gimmick that we
had before,
the players answer questions, they still have that?
Well, no, they got a thing where you go around the concourse and they sign autographs.
Yeah, it's basically just the team so bad, nobody wants.
year.
But like during the game, down there in the game, nothing's going on, and the fans don't get a chance to really meet these guys.
Oh, where they put the questions. Players up on the scoreboard, and they're like, what's your favorite Pop-Tart or whatever? That's your big idea? Hilarious. That's what you're giving me? All right.
Well, I got a little something new, too.
What, all right, give me something new. Give me something more exciting.
Well, because I don't know if we can do the Lambo, but we can do a turnover throne. We got to have a gimmick. We got to have a throne, a giant throne in the south end zone.
I do that. See, I do that, but I would also give the player, a ornate Spartan sword and then have him go kill one of the opponents. That's what I would do.
There you go.
See, haven't you killed enough Wolverines? I would do this, Mike. I think you don't need a throne. You don't need a sword.